In this After Effects tutorial, I'm going to show you how to animate abstract graphic posters. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. This works for any kind of format. You can use this kind of technique to create your own unique posters or loops. So, let's get started, shall we? First of all, we create a new comp. Name it base animation, size 1000 by 1000 pixels. In this comp, the actual shape animation is happening. So let's animate. We double click on the rectangle tool to create a new shape. No stroke, but a dark blue fill, or whatever color you want it to be. We name it square small. We open the position property and the rectangle path property and set keyframes for the path size and the position at 50 frames. We press U to only see these two properties in the timeline. At 60 frames, we set the size to 250 pixels, the position to x875. Next, with no layer selected, we double click on the rounded rectangle tool to create a round shape. Fill color, this time yellow. Let's name it circle. We open its path property and position property. At 50 frames, we set path size and position keyframes. Set the path size to 0. And the X position to 0 as well. At 60 frames, we set the size to 750, the X position to 375. Then we select all four keyframes, go to the keyframe assistant and add easy ease to them. We open the graph editor and edit the speed graph. We slow down the beginning and the end of the animations even more by dragging the handles inwards. Wait for it, awesome. Let's move on to 80 frames. We set keyframes for all four properties. If you want to avoid movement in between, I recommend turning these into toggle hold keyframes. We use the rectangle tool again to create another square shape. Fill color, some kind of cyan or bright blue. Let's name it square big. We move it below the small square and move the start point to 80 frames. We open the position property and set the X value to minus 500 and set a keyframe. Let's move on to 90 frames. We set keyframes for all properties again. We move the position of the small square to x1625, the big square, 0. We increase the size of the circle to 1000 pixels, and we set the position to x1000. We select all 10 keyframes and add easy ease. Then go into the graph editor and adjust the speed graphs. And awesome! Let's create a new comp and let's name it Line. 2500 by 250 pixels. We add the base animation comp, scale it down to 25%. The sides are 250 pixels long now, a quarter of the original size. So we position the comp at the left edge, x125. One option would be to add the CC reptile effect and expand to the right. Let's add a number. Alright, the thing is, all the animations happen at the same time. That's not what we want, so we delete the effect again and duplicate the comp and add 250 pixels to the X value. Literally, plus 250. The comp width. And so on. Duplicate the comp, move it to the right, until the comp is completely filled. We close all the position properties. Then we offset the comps by 2 frames each. I think it's easier to select all of them. And that creates the time-shifted animation. Awesome. Then we create the actual poster comp. HD resolution this time, 16 by 9, 240 frames long. Then we add the line comp to it and position it at the top. We duplicate it and this time we add plus 250 to the Y position. You probably fear it. Repeat until the comp is filled. Then we select all of them and position them overall. Awesome. Let's set the work area start to 50 frames. And again, offset the comps by 1 frame each. Awesome. That's the overall setup. If you like this video so far, please give it a thumbs up. I'd really appreciate it. Thanks very much. Let's get back to the base animation comp and animate the rest of it. At 110 frames, we set keyframes again. At 120 frames, we set the size of the small square to 1000, the position to x 1250, the square big position to x -250. We reduce the size of the circle to 500 and set the X position to 500, so it's basically squeezed in between. Again, we add easy ease to all the new keyframes and use the graph editor to further adjust the speed graph. You need to adjust all handles at the same time to make sure the objects move all at the same pace at a time. Let's move the work area start to 50 frames. At 140 pixels, we set keyframes. At 150 frames, we set the size of the small square back to 500. The X position to 750. The square big X position to 0. The circle size to 0 as well. Again, we add easy ease to the new keyframes and adjust the speed curve. If the peaks of the curves are roughly the same height, the animations overall have roughly the same speed. At 170 frames, we set keyframes again. At 180 frames, we set the square small size to 1000, the X position to 500, the square big position to 500 as well. And one last time, we add easy ease to adjust the lower 6 keyframes and we adjust the speed curve. Let's have a look at what we've done. Awesome, we just created a seamless loop, by the way. You could add a background gradient, you could add new shapes and colors, move shapes up and down as well. All the scale and position values depend on the size of the comp you choose, so it's best to figure out the comp size before you start. You could add it to a vertical comp, rotate it, add some bold type to it, and use it as Insta story or stuff like that. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell, because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, guys.